It's my feel good breakfast show.
Welcome back, everybody. This is your Feel Good Breakfast Show on S3. Happy Monday to all of you. Now, this man is an OG, everybody.
Oh, yes.
Theo Watts is a name that's been in the music industry for 3 decades. He's the former lead singer of the well-known group The Rockets, who have toured to countries like Egypt, Australia, and the Seychelles. Now, Theo Watts has recently embarked on a solo career, and he joined us this morning to tell us all about it. Please, can we give him a warm Feel Good welcome, everybody?
Yes, 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 yes.
OG.
Theo, how you doing?
Finally, it's good being here with you guys, man.
I gotta say, I absolutely love the shoes, man. You just absolutely nailed Monday, yeah. You came with all the feels, brother. But look, you like we said, you're an absolute OG. You've been in the game for so long, and not only in South Africa, but you've been traveling the world, right? You've got experience, you've got accolades, and you've got so much achievements. How's this kind of prepped you for this big moment where you're literally going solo, man?
Yes, well, it was a brave decision, you know, because I've been with the Rockets about for 32 years.
Yeah, that's like family, right?
Yeah, it's like family, you know, because we're still in contact with each other and all that. But when I broke away from the band, I wanted to do my own thing, write my own songs, you know, and especially like the songs that I'm writing is like stuff that is happening here, and especially here in Cape Town, and I'm enjoying it, you know.
What was that moment where you said, you know what, I've loved working with the Rockets, you know, they have been my family for the longest time, but now it's time to find my own little journey, my own little path, and find out what Theo Watts wants to do. What was that moment for you?
You see, actually, being with the Rockets was a learning curve for me, but I felt like, listen, like writing my own stuff and all that, you know, especially that. But now, lately, it must relate especially to the children. That's why I'm writing songs of gender-based violence and all that, of what is happening here in Cape Town, you know.
How is that? I mean, obviously, you've got your own flavor when you come from a group and you've got your sort of recipe for success.
Yes.
Now you're going on your own. You're kind of, in some sense, I'd imagine, you mentioned it's a stepping stone, so to speak, but you're also kind of almost identify with yourself again. You're realizing new things about yourself and within your music as well.
Yes.
How's that changed now that you've been on your own? How's that started to form? You mentioned obviously representing songs and issues like GBV. How's this emancipation?
To be quite honest with you guys, I'm feeling very free. I'm free. That's why I can write down stuff for, especially for Namakwaland.
Yeah.
People out there. Because I was the writer of Namakwa Daisy, and now there's another one, Aganese, and also another one, Die Trane van die Kaap.
Okay.
Ah. You know, Die Trane van die Kaap is based on, as we speak now, about crossfiring, you know, children, innocent children being shot, you know, going to school and all that, gender-based violence, all the bullying at school. You know what I mean? It's a scary feeling, actually, but you know what I mean?
Yeah.
You've done so much in the music industry and the music space. You've been able to meet people like Usher, Luther Vandross. What was that experience like, being able to rub shoulders with the who's who of the entertainment business?
You know, being with Usher, we've learned a lot from Usher. The most humble guy, in the, because his mom was his manager, actually, before he fired her.
Wow, why not? That really does.
And you know what happened? I took a picture with Usher, but that was before the cell phones, man. Remember that camera?
We had to wait for it to
be developed.
By that time, Bianca was with us also. Bianca LaGrange.
Okay,
it was all of us. We did Johannesburg, we did Durban, so we came to Greenpoint with Alicia Keys and everybody. All of them, P. Diddy, But after, when I took the pictures, nothing came out.
So, you know, you have no pictures. Now you just have the memories of meeting these people, but we have the memories embedded in our brain because you, like I said, are an OG, and we are so happy that you're with us today. Theo Watts, remember that name. He's not going anywhere. He has 3 magical performances coming your way on your Feel Good Breakfast show.